Cameron, I think you should get more sleep. I've noticed you've been really tired recently.
Bro, I gotta get this under control, bro. Like, I can't keep having bad practices because I can't sleep. I gotta really. Maybe I should try cognitive behavioral therapy. Hopeless therapists help the way I behave and it changed the way I think. That could really help with my sleep pattern.
Oh, whoa.
It's not too far from here.
What's up, Dr. Buffoon?
How you doing, Mr. Cameron?
Got some concerns I would like to talk to you about.
All right.
I'm having trouble sleeping, and I feel as though it's causing my problems in football. I can't be having those things because I want to succeed and be well in football, but I can't sleep at night. And it's also causing bad grades. I have all F's. All F's.
Do you know how many hours of sleep you get at night?
Two.
2 hours. Well, you know, most college students go through the same thing as you. Because generally, college students need about 8 hours of sleep at night. But because of workload on assignments, professors usually take away that hours because you're studying up doing homework. Especially you being an athlete, you should get at least 9 to 10 hours of sleep so it can help with your performance on the field and in the classroom.
Okay, Dr. Buffoon. I'll really try my best to incorporate your advice. But is there any other advice you can give me? Because I really want to succeed in school and do well in the field.
Well, for a matter of fact, my man right here, Dr. Borders, he might
actually
be able to help you.
How you doing, sir?
How you doing, Dr. Borders?
What's been going on with you, sir?
I've been having a lot of sleep problems, man. It has been messing up my head.
What do you think is the cause of the sleep? Is it stress?
Yeah, I think it is. It might be stress.
Stress is a very common thing among college students, especially athletes. Maybe you should try a coping mechanism, such as meditation. This can really help with your stress and ease your stress, help you go to sleep better, such as mindfulness. You focus on the present and like where you are in the present, and this can help you succeed on and off the field. Have you ever tried meditation before?
Honestly, Dr. Borders, it hasn't crossed my mind to try meditation.
Okay. Maybe you should just give it a try. Let me know how it goes for you, okay?
Okay, I will.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Borders. Now, Cameron, have you heard about the 4 stages of sleep?
No, enlighten me.
Well, stage 1 is the non-REM stage, and it's really the 5 to 10 minute stage. And it's the transition period before you wakeness and falling asleep. In stage 2, your body temperature drops and your heart rate begins to slow. And your brain begins to produce sleep spindles. And it lasts approximately 20 minutes. In stage 3, it's non-REM stage 3. And your muscles relax, your blood pressure and breathing rate drop, and that is also your deepest sleep. After the 3rd stage, you hit your REM sleep, which is when your body becomes more active and when your dreams occur. This cycle should happen around 4 times a night if you're getting the right amount of sleep. Each cycle should take about 90 minutes. Do you understand that, Mr. Cameron?
Hey.
I think I have to wrap that around my head.
Hey, Mr. Cameron, I had one more thing to tell you. So, along with meditation, you should also try different study techniques. Because if you do that, then you won't be up studying so late. You can get the proper rest, which will help with your memory when you take your tests. Maybe you should try studying in little sections, take little breaks, study in groups. All of these things will help you so that you don't stay up late and you can be A-okay on your tests.
Woo! Yeah! Dirty and dirty, huh? I'm the best man.
I'm too sexy for Milan. Too sexy for Milan, New York.
Too sexy for your game, too sexy for this fame, yeah, yeah.
questions.